So today we have Wendy, and Wendy's here to help us all live to 110. She's founder and head writer of livetoo110.com. She's a certified holistic health coach, a nutritionist, and a hair mineral analyst. She is a serious maniac when it comes to detoxing. She's pretty much amazing at everything, and she'll be talking today about an extremely effective strategy for detoxing unwanted chemicals from our body. So let's give Wendy a warm welcome.
Okay, great. Hello. I think that's good. You guys hear me? Well, thank you guys for coming. I am so excited about the Bulletproof conference and checking out all the toys that they have here for to play with. So my name is Wendy Myers, and today I want to talk to you about the importance of detoxification. There are over 100,000 chemicals in our environment, in addition to toxic heavy metals. And these, coupled with mineral and nutrient deficiencies, I believe are the underlying true cause of disease. And unless you have a lifelong daily detoxification strategy, the odds are you are going to be one of the statistics of the high rate of disease that we have today in this country. So how did I get into detoxification and health? My father was diagnosed with cancer, with esophageal cancer, and he was dead within 6 months many years ago. And that scared me to death. And his death was very painful, and he did not die well. And so I decided that I needed to do everything possible to prevent that. I did not want to get cancer. It's a real wake-up call for me. So that started me on an odyssey to learn all about natural health and what causes cancer. I had so many questions. Why are so many people being diagnosed with cancer? 1 in 2 men and 1 in 3 women. Why is there such a high prevalence of autoimmune disease? And so in answering all these questions and researching, I founded livetoo110.com to communicate and write about my research and make it available to all you guys. So I think that one of the main ways, one of the best ways that people can detox all of these heavy metals and chemicals is through infrared saunas. Such an amazing, easy, low-tech strategy to detox all these metals from your body. So let's talk a little bit about infrared saunas and why you want to detox. Like I said, there's 100,000 chemicals in our environment. There's new ones every day. Every year, there's thousands more released. None of these, very few of them, have been tested for safety on humans. Not to mention there's dozens of heavy metals in our environment. There's arsenic, there's lead, there's mercury. So many. I can't list them all right now because I'm so nervous. there's also phthalates in our environment. Phthalates are one of the number one chemicals in our body. Phthalates are used to keep perfume and color in your shampoo. So your shampoo, if it's pink and it's bubblegum flavor, that stays in your hair. Even after you wash out that toxic sludge, it stays in your hair and you continue to smell like bubblegum. Same thing with toxic Tide. Your clothes will still continue to smell like Tide for days and even weeks. And that's phthalates keeping that color and that scent in your fabric. And there's also fragrance. Fragrance is in all personal care products. You pretty much can't escape this. If a product says fragrance on it, it will also contain phthalates. The word fragrance usually will contain about 100 other chemicals, but manufacturers use the word fragrance to be able to hide their proprietary scent. There's also parabens in our environment. These are hormone disruptors. Parabens are used as preservatives in all of your products, methylparaben, butylparaben, propylparaben. And they preserve the product so they last for years and years on the shelves because consumers want that. There's also BPA and BPS. These are plastic hardeners that are also hormone disruptors. They mimic estrogen in our bodies. And many people are, you know, proud to buy BPA-free products. But guess what? Now they have BPS in them, which is actually 19 to 20 times worse than BPA. So because BPA has gotten a lot of media scrutiny, now manufacturers just use something else that's even worse. And when BPS finally gets media scrutiny, is taken out of products, there'll be BPB, BPC, BPD, BPA. There's the whole alphabet of plastic hardeners. And then there are pesticides. Obviously, we don't need to get into that. We know pesticides are bad for us, they're estrogenic, they can cause cancer, they can cause all kinds of diseases. Then there are halogens. This is something a lot of people aren't aware of. Halogens block thyroid function. They block iodine. They compete with iodine to get into your thyroid, and your thyroid hormones are made of iodine. So obviously, if you have chlorine and fluoride in your water that you're taking a shower in every day, these substances are added to all the municipal water sources, most of them in the United States. And that this is one of the reasons why people, two-thirds of the U.S. is obese or overweight, because their thyroids are not working, and the thyroid sets your metabolic rate. So this is a big one, that halogens are detoxed by infrared saunas. So why do we want to use an infrared sauna? Namely, to detox all of these chemicals that I just listed, but there's so many other benefits. Where we want to get out all these chemicals that I discussed, and also the toxic heavy metals. Toxic heavy metals have been around in our environment since Paleolithic times. Our bodies do know how to detox these metals, but there, because of industry dredging up all these metals from the environment and mining and the burning of coal, releases mercury into the environment. Huge problem with China, the coal burning in China, spewing all this mercury into the environment. It's settling in the oceans, and it's poisoning our seafood supply. Many of my clients who do hair mineral analysis with me, if they drink well water in the Western United States, that a lot of them have mercury toxicity from drinking their well water, which they thought was pristine, and it's from the coal burning that's going on in China and the United States as well. So while there's so many more toxic heavy metals in our environment than there were in Paleolithic man times, it's very important for us to assist our bodies to get these metals out of our bodies, because our bodies are so overwhelmed, so overburdened with all of these hundreds and thousands of chemicals and heavy metals that we have to give it some assistance with infrared saunas. Additionally, we have, I can't read this, we need to detox radioactive minerals as well, like cesium and uranium as well. Any of you guys worried about Fukushima? You can detox the cesium that is in seafood with the infrared sauna. You just sweat them out. Additionally, you can kill chronic infections. We want to kill chronic infections like fungus, parasites, any cold and flu viruses. There's candida as well, any kind of gut dysbiosis. These infections do not tolerate heat very well. When you get in an infrared sauna, you heat up your body temperature about 2 to 3 degrees. And in doing that, you induce this faux fever that will kill off all these parasites. You wouldn't believe with my clients how many parasites that they're expelling, and they're getting rid of systemic candida infections, and so many benefits of going in infrared sauna, including killing colds and flu. If I start to get a cold, I feel a little bit sick, I go into my infrared sauna more than normal, and I will prevent the viral replication, and I will reduce the length of time I have a cold. Additionally, infrared saunas are very well known for killing cancer tumors and mutated cells that could turn into a cancer tumor. And it definitely needs to be a part of any cancer treatment protocol. The heat is very effective at killing cancer cells, even cancer cells you don't even know that you have. We all get cancer cells in our bodies many, many times over the course of our lives. But if you have a strong immune system, you're taking lots of minerals, your immune system and body will be strong enough to kill it off. However, it's when your body becomes so overburdened with chemicals, so overburdened with heavy metals, and it's weakened, that's when you're not able to kill it off and it will grow into a tumor. It's a simplified version, but you get the idea. So an infrared sauna is very effective at killing these tumors because they're very intolerant of heat. Next one is pain relief. They're very well known among athletes that the infrared saunas can reduce pain. It can also reduce muscle recovery time, workout recovery. It's very effective at many things of that nature. Also, enhanced wound healing. Obviously, you want to keep an infection out of a wound. So using an infrared sauna or just even a single infrared bulb, shining it on an area of infection, really speeds up the healing a lot. Then the next one is oxygenating your cells. By using an infrared sauna, you basically are the cells are able to release their toxins, and you also increase circulation in the body, and this helps to oxygenate your cells and the tissues, which is obviously very good at healing disease and preventing disease as well. The next one is reducing stress. I know a lot of you guys are probably going, oh, I have to see every booth at the Bulletproof Conference, and it's a little bit stressful. So the infrared sauna is very good at tapping into your parasympathetic nervous system. This is the part of your nervous system you need to access to be able to detox. And most people are in their sympathetic mode. That's their fight or flight. I have a million things to do today, working. That's the stress mode. And when you're in that mode, you cannot detox. And so that's why stress kills. It's namely because people are not able to detox, and they just start accumulating heavy metals and building them up in their body. And that's one of the reasons why stress kills. So we need you to get into your parasympathetic mode, and the infrared sauna helps us to tap into that part of our nervous system. So now, what kind of saunas are there? I'm sure you guys have heard of the traditional sauna, the traditional Swedish or Finnish sauna. There's also far infrared saunas, and near infrared sauna is my favorite. So I'll go into some of these. First, there's a traditional sauna. I mean, don't you want to be in a sauna with this guy, sweating and making small talk? Don't you love sweating? So this is the sauna most people are familiar with. It's a sauna that will be at your gym, typically. It just uses heat. These typically are really, really hot. They're at 180, even 200 and more degrees. And I don't know about you, but I can't stay very long in a traditional sauna, maybe max 15 minutes. Certainly someone that's ill cannot stay in a sauna very long that's hot, or that's that hot. And the heat in the traditional sauna, it will penetrate about 1 to 2 millimeters. You're only getting some toxin release, about 1 or 2 millimeters in your skin. And so it's really not that effective, though it is a little bit effective for detoxing in these kind of saunas. So you want to upgrade, go to a far infrared sauna. These are the kind of saunas that you'll see at high-end beauty spas and in health clinics and things of that nature. There's one at my acupuncture spa that I go to. And they use carbon panels to heat up the environment. And the rays are very effective at penetrating your body. They penetrate about 1 to 2 inches. And they heat you from the inside out to help to release your toxins inside your cells. The only drawback with these is they can release EMFs, electromagnetic fields, which we don't want. A lot of people have sensitivity to that, whether they're aware of it or not. So that can be a problem in the cheaper models. And it's also an issue because a lot of these also have thermostats. And what happens with a thermostat when you reach the desired temperature, 150 degrees, the thermostat turns off. So the infrared rays turn off, which is the whole point of being in the sauna. So that's the only drawback with these, because the sauna may be turning off and on and off and on, so you're not getting the full benefit of consistent infrared ray penetration and detox. Then my favorite sauna is a near-infrared sauna. It just uses 4 light bulbs, as you can see, and you can put it in any kind of enclosure. You can put it in your bathroom, in a tent, a small room, a small closet, what have you. And these bulbs are very inexpensive. You can find them at any hardware store. They're called heat lamps. They're also the same bulbs that are used to heat up hamburgers at McDonald's. Because they do a very good job of heating you up from the inside as well as heating up the hamburgers. So these are my preferred method of infrared sauna use, which I'll get into more in a minute. So what are near-infrared bulbs? They're just bulbs you buy at your hardware store called heat lamps. You want them to be 250 watts, and they only cost $10, not expensive. Then they also emit near and middle infrared rays, so you get a larger spectrum of infrared rays. And they also, like I said, they heat you from the inside out so that the cells can dump their toxic contents. And it also penetrates deeper than a far infrared sauna. It penetrates about 3 to 4 inches inside you because it concentrates the infrared rays in a much smaller area. You would have your bulbs and you just have them facing your trunk. And then you kind of rotate like a little rotisserie chicken. You do 15 minutes or 30 minutes on your front and then switch to do the backside. You can also do your left or right side if you like. You want to be thorough. And like I said, they're only $10. So not expensive. And so let's talk about some of the differences between near and far infrared saunas. I think I went over some of these already. The infrared rays of near infrared penetrate deeper, which is obviously more desirable. They're inexpensive. Some of the far infrared saunas can run, you know, several thousand dollars to even $10,000. Not accessible for a lot of people. So the near infrared saunas, I sell one on my website for $350, a little portable one. And you can also get one for $1,200, a full-size one. So not terribly expensive. Also, the near-infrared saunas have very low or no EMFs, those electromagnetic fields that I talked about. And these are a problem with cell phone use and any kind of wireless technology that we enjoy. They also cause problems with our cells and with our electrical system and our bodies. So you don't want to buy a cheap far infrared sauna because a lot of them, the ones from China, have alarming rate of EMFs, have high EMFs in them if people do readings with gadgets that read EMFs. So that's a big problem, but the near infrared saunas don't emit those or just very, very little. Near-infrared saunas actually have another benefit. They increase the death of mutated cells that could eventually turn malignant. So that's what the studies show is that they're more beneficial of killing those mutated cells than far-infrared saunas. They also produce focused healing. You can just buy one bulb with a little fixture. And the focused healing of those is very good to, if you just want to put the bulb on one area of your body. I have some of my clients that use an infrared bulb to heal a wound, or they have a muscle strain, or they have thyroid issues, they'll shine it on their thyroid. Other people will shine it on their toenail fungus, and it's extremely effective at killing that as well, so that people don't have to take toxic antifungals that's bad for your liver, or, you know, broad-spectrum systemic antibiotics. I have lots of clients that have surgery, and they'll just use the light bulb on their surgical incision, and it heals it right up. Extremely effective. And I have near-infrared saunas on my website. I have these little four-bulb contractions that are portable, and I'm actually going to give one away for free today. So if you guys want to enter the little contest to win one, take out your cell phones. And you can text the word detox to 38470. And so you'll also get my, learn more information about infrared saunas and get on my email list. You can learn all about what I'm up to, get email updates. So again, you wanna text the word detox to 38470. And I'll do a drawing at the end of the day so that one of you guys can win one of these lovely saunas. And then I talked already about single infrared heat lamp therapy. I've got an article on my website you can read more, you know, to get directions and all the benefits of using just a single bulb. I also have these available on my website as well. And I have an upcoming book. It's called The Modern Paleo Survival Guide. I think I wanted to write this book because I think a lot of people are missing the boat if they're just eating a healthy paleo type diet and living a healthy lifestyle. If you don't have that third piece of the puzzle, which is detox, you could be one of the statistics. I have a lot of clients that eat very healthy and have for years. They sleep 8 hours a night. They work out every morning, go jogging. And they are still perplexed as to why they have health symptoms, why they have brain fog, or even diagnosed with a disease or a serious health condition. And it's because they're missing that detox element. And that's one of my main messages on live2110.com is that you have to have a lifelong daily detox strategy to prevent disease. And so I urge all of you out there to not wait until you get sick, not wait until you are given a disease label. You need to start today to start thinking about preventing disease. And one of the best ways to do that is with a near-infrared sauna. So thank you guys so much for listening, and that's my talk. And so, So this, I'm going to, you know, open the room up for questions.
And I'll pass around a mic here.
Do you have a question? I think he has a question.
Yeah, Wendy, this has been a great talk and sort of rekindled my interest in detox, which I have done a lot historically, but it's been a few years since I've done a routine practice on this. Curious about combining sauna with colon cleansing, clay, other practices to help remove toxins. Is that something that's part of your practice?
Absolutely. Yeah, I have a program called Mineral Power, and I absolutely combine coffee enemas. Actually, a lot of my clients use Bulletproof coffee. and I combine that. They're actually not for colon cleansing. They're for detoxing the liver. That's the main purpose of them. But yeah, I combine that along with the infrared saunas. But also taking minerals. People don't realize when they're mineral deficient, they retain other heavy metals that can do certain jobs in the body if the body is deficient in minerals. So actually taking minerals is a big part of detoxification. And when you tank up on minerals, the body will start to just naturally release heavy metals. It's really interesting.
Hi, my name's Dan Pena, and I'll be 70 my next birthday. And I test for what you're talking about at least yearly. And I don't have any results for heavy metals, et cetera. And other than trying to live healthy, what do you attribute the fact that I'm as old as I am and I live healthy, but I don't have any of the things that you're attesting to?
Well, most of my clients don't have heavy metals showing up on their tests either. And that is because your body is too tired to release them. And so that's what part of my program Mineral Power, takes 2 to 3 years to detox the bulk of heavy metals. And most of my clients, like they do fecal tests, they'll do the urine push tests with synthetic chelators, or they'll do a hair mineral analysis, which is what I do. And many of them don't have anything coming out because it takes energy to detox. So only when the body has sufficient energy will it start releasing heavy metals. And the body's using some of these heavy metals, so it won't release them. If it's using them, and if there's mineral deficiency. Yeah, I know. But see, that's the thing. Your body is retaining them. It's not releasing them. So it's if you're not releasing heavy metals, it won't show up on a test. And so that's why people have to do a long-term detoxification program in order for metals to start showing up on tests. Because everyone has heavy metals. The only question is to what degree. Everybody has them. So I'd be happy to consult with you to help you to get rid of some of those heavy metals.
Just a practical question. When using the bulbs, at what distance from the body do you use them? Is it to increase the temperature in the environment, or to actually do it at a specific place on the surface of the skin? And what's the optimal distance?
Yeah, well, when you're using an infrared sauna that has about 4 bulbs, you want it just close enough to where it doesn't burn you, and that's going to be about 18 inches. But of course, you want to move away from it if it's getting too hot or change your position. With a single bulb, it'd probably be about 1 foot from you, but you just gauge it individually.
So it's not to heat up the environment in enclosed space like a small bathroom?
Well, in order to sweat, you do have to heat up the environment. Using a single bulb or just the 4 bulbs, you probably won't heat up that much. It will some. But I use another space heater inside of my shower where I have my little portable sauna hanging. So it is very important to sweat. The infrared rays do heat up your body from the inside, but you want to heat up the environment a little bit as well with just a simple space heater to induce more sweating as well.
A couple of questions. One is, what's the website? What's your website?
Yeah, it's livetoo110.com.
The next one is, what's the average, recommended average time that you would use daily? And what's the depth? We talked about 1 millimeter or so for the first traditional one. The second one was 1 or 2 inches or so.
Yeah.
With the far infrared sauna, what's the depth that you could reach?
The far infrared sauna is roughly 1 to 2 inches, and the near infrared sauna is 3 to 4 inches. The average estimated depth of penetration. And you want to use a sauna when you're doing a detox, an initial detox program. You have to use one pretty intensely for about 2 to 3 years. So I say 5 to 7 days a week for the first 2 to 3 years. And then after that, maybe twice a week to detox any new chemicals that you're encountering in your environment. That's why you have to, an initial intense detox and then a lifelong detox strategy. And so, yeah, when you first start, you want to do about 15 to 20 minutes to start out. And then you just, you know, gauge it. Everyone's a little bit different. Gauge it. Increase it up to 30 to 60 minutes a day. It's livetoo110.com. Yeah, okay.
From my research on far infrared sauna, I've found out that also you can burn a lot of calories.
Yes, you can. Yeah.
So I doubt you weren't showing that in the list of benefits.
Yeah, I didn't go over all of them. There's so many, okay. But that is one of them. Weight loss is really not the focus so much. But yeah, you do can burn 100 to 200 calories a session.
So I'm actually in the process of building a far infrared sauna in my house.
Yeah.
Lucky girl. So would you recommend adding the near infrared light bulbs to it?
Yes, you can. Yeah, it will increase the benefits, and it's not an expensive way to modify it. And I do recommend people, if they have a far infrared, to add some near infrared bulbs.
Yeah, so I'm literally just about to finish building it, so I haven't finished it. Wouldn't the near infrared light bulbs heat up the room, so then the far infrared heaters would go off sooner?
Probably, yeah. Yeah, but at least with the bulbs, it'll be consistent near infrared rays hitting you. Whereas when the thermostat clicks the far infrared rays to turn off, you'll still get rays penetrating you.
So combination of two is the best option then. Okay,
yeah.
Thank you.
A practical question for the near infrared lights: does that need to be on your skin, or could you have clothing on?
No, they don't penetrate clothing. That's a very good question. So you do have to be naked or in your bathing suit.
Thank you.
Yeah.
What about full spectrum saunas? Mm-hmm.
Yes, well, there are some more expensive models like Sunlighten that have the near, middle, and far infrared rays. I've been in a Sunlighten, and you couldn't choose which spectrum that you wanted. You just had to do a setting like for pain relief or wound healing, or they had different settings. But you weren't able to choose which spectrum that you wanted. So different spectrums have different benefits. The near-infrared rays pretty much cover the whole spectrum of benefits. They're just a little bit different. It's not really that much of a concern. I just tell people far, near, great. Just get into a sauna.
Hi. I haven't seen your website, but I'll check you out. Okay. Can you walk us through a little bit about the testing? I know you mentioned that you do mineral testing, and you're using a hair analysis process.
Yes.
Can you talk about that?
Yes. I do a program called Mineral Power. It uses a hair mineral analysis to assess your mineral levels and your heavy metal toxicities. It's actually, you know, most people think of it as just looking at what your heavy metals are and what your mineral levels are. But it actually took me several years to learn how to read and assess the hair tests and the ratios and the patterns, ratios to certain minerals to each other, calcium, magnesium. It's actually a very, very complicated science that was developed by Dr. Paul Eck, furthered by Dr. David Watts and Dr. Lawrence Wilson. So a lot of doctors do testing at doctor's data, and they incorrectly read the testing. This is why a lot of people don't find that it's accurate, because it's not when you are just looking at the hair mineral analysis and looking at calcium levels. If it's high calcium, you don't supplement calcium. High zinc, don't supplement zinc. That's not how it works. Nothing is that simple. The body is not simple. So reading the hair test and interpreting it is very complicated science. So I design a custom supplement program based on a hair mineral analysis to more so not to correct the imbalances on the hair test. And everyone needs calcium, magnesium, zinc. Everybody across the board. I also supplement kelp for trace minerals. And I also provide people an entire program using saunas, using coffee enemas, using other detox methods and lifestyle and diet recommendations, using my modern paleo diet. And it really is very effective at healing disease, reversing disease, ameliorating and mitigating any kind of symptom, the vague ones that doctors can't treat, like brain fog and fatigue, which a lot of people are suffering from once they get into their 30s and even earlier. So mineral deficiency is rampant in our society and is one of the main underlying causes of diseases that I try to address on the program.
Two questions real quick. One, I'm right here.
Oh, hi.
Hi. So there are a couple of, you're talking about the full spectrum, like the Sunlighten saunas. There's some new saunas like West Coast that have come out with ceramic and far, and they get a lot hotter. Do you have any recommendations between the hotter version and the regular version is increased heat. Does that increase?
It doesn't increase the benefits.
Okay.
In fact, you can use a near-infrared sauna at just 110 degrees.
Okay.
And that's crucial for some people that have cancer. They're very ill or frail or old. So you don't really need more heat. It doesn't provide more benefits. It's more about the infrared rays penetrating you.
Okay.
But more heat will get you sweating. I can't tolerate a sauna over 150 degrees.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just too much. Well, you know, typically saunas are either ceramic or the carbon base. Some of them are just heat emitters. But I don't really see any increased benefit to having both.
Great. And then just one more. I have a doctor that does doctor's data results for my clients for mercury poisoning. And I actually had it done myself about 3 years ago, and it showed that I had mercury poisoning. And when I looked online and kind of did a little research with doctor's data, it says when you're chelating, and they like basically chelate you and then have you pee, that they're all going to be artificially increased. Is there truth to that? What's your
Absolutely. Because you're putting in a synthetic chelator, it's going to grab all the metals that you have and take them out, and you'll see it in the hair and in the urine and the feces and other places. And that's fine, but that's not, it's not really, it doesn't really give you a lot of information because everybody has these metal toxicities. Everybody does. So for me, the hair test is more about seeing the patterns of the minerals so that I can supplement in a way that improves their body chemistry. It's not really so much to see the heavy metal levels. Most people don't have heavy metal levels on their initial tests, especially the sicker they are. They tend to not have, or the less energy they have, they tend to not have metals for various reasons as well. I don't like doctor's data because they wash the hair prior to testing it. When you wash the hair, you wash away water-soluble minerals like sodium and potassium, and that's key to being able to see someone's adrenal function and their metabolic rate. And that is key in being able to properly give someone the right supplements that they need to correct their metabolic rate and other nutrient deficiencies. So, and I also don't, I don't like doctor's data for a number of other reasons as well. I think it's more useful for people to see a graph so they can visually see what's going on. I also don't like the doctor's data uses a spectrum. They have a certain range of analysis. Just a number of reasons I don't like them. I prefer to use ideal values, like calcium should be at 40 and things of that nature. This is an ideal range that healthy people should have, rather than seeing a large range like doctor's data uses. I don't think that's very useful.
And they were selling the saunas.
Yes.
I don't know if they are near or far. Now I kind of want to go back and see. Mm-hmm. But they had like a full body one where you sit in it.
Mm-hmm.
And then they had one for just the legs and then one for just the feet.
Yeah.
If you say you were to use the one for just the feet, or it sounds like you have like a little spot heater, so it only will work on your feet, or does putting your feet in there at least put some benefit to the rest of your body?
No, you have to be in a fully enclosed sauna. That's why I don't like the ones where your head pops out, because I want to detox my head. I don't know about you guys. the foot one will detox your feet. If you have any kind of foot issues, but it will heat up your body. Even just using a single bulb will heat up your body to a degree, but not as much as a full body sauna. So they were probably far infrared. Those are not going to be near infrared.
And so the one that you have that you're giving away, it looks like it's almost like a space heater.
It's not a space heater. It's just a contraption that has sockets for four bulbs. Yes. Well, you can hang it, and there's different ways you can hang it. There's a big long chain. You can hang it from your shower head. You can fix it to the wall or whatever your little sauna enclosure that you built for it. And you basically just you want it facing your trunk because that's the main area we want to detox. And then you can just rotate. I do 30 minutes on my front, and then turn around and do 30 minutes on my back. And it gets everywhere.
Yeah. Okay. To continue with her, you put it in the shower.
Yeah.
That would be considered your enclosure as long as it's heat. The purpose of the enclosure is to heat it up.
Yes,
is that
to
it?
Retain
okay.
the heat.
Okay.
Yeah.
I was at drmercola.com, and there was an interesting woman who, this is not about detoxing, but the benefits were about increasing human growth hormone. Yes. Is that more had to do with heat, or does that have to do with this infrared?
You know, I honestly don't know the answer to that question. I know it does increase the stimulation of human growth hormone just because of the many benefits that it has in the body. It increases heat shock proteins. It has so many different benefits. There's hundreds and hundreds of studies that have been done, lots in Japan, about the benefits of infrared saunas. You can find more information. There's a great book written by Dr. Lawrence Wilson called Sauna Therapy. And that will go into all the many different benefits and the exact mechanisms behind why it'll increase human growth hormone.
I was just trying to figure out if it was the heat that she was talking about, or if it was the infrared, near infrared, far infrared.
It's probably the infrared, but okay. I don't know.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much.